Okay.
Good morning, welcome. My name is Chaplain Kathy Nixie. I'm Director of Spiritual Life for UMH. Welcome to this time of worship where we will walk with Jesus through the events of Holy Week and right to the foot of the cross. I wish we could all be together in a more personal way, but I'm so grateful for those who are able to gather with me today and for those who have gathered with me via our channel 12. Sit back, listen, pray, meditate on what you hear, and sing along as you are able. And now we begin our Lenten journey with Jesus to the foot of the cross. Today, through scripture and song, we remember the day that Jesus willingly suffered and died on the cross as the ultimate sacrifice for our sins. Through Jesus conquering death, he makes possible for us the way to eternal life with God. We will tell the story of Jesus' journey from the Last Supper in the upper room all the way to his journey to the cross. Let's pray. O God of infinite love and power, we gather together on this Good Friday to reflect on the passion of the Christ. We are utterly humbled in the presence of such love and mercy. Open our hearts this day to the goodness of Good Friday and fill us with your love and powerful spirit of holiness. Remove from us all sin. Offer us anew your life in Christ that makes all things new. And we continue in prayer now with the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from Isaiah chapter 53, verses 3 through 6. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we did not esteem him. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Andrea, would you mind closing the back door?
I count but loss.
A reading from Matthew chapter 26, various verses. In the evening, Jesus was at the table with the 12 followers. They were all eating. Then Jesus said, "Believe me when I say that one of you 12 here will hand me over to my enemies." The followers were very sad to hear this. Each one said, "Lord, surely I am not the one." Jesus answered, "One who has dipped his bread in the same bowl with me will be the one to hand me over. The Son of Man will suffer what the scriptures say will happen to him. But it will be very bad for the one who hands over the Son of Man to be killed. It would be better for him if he had never been born." Then Judas, the very one who would hand him over, said to Jesus, "Teacher, surely I am not the one you are talking about, am I?" Jesus answered, "Yes, it is you." Then Jesus told them, "This very night you will all fall away on account of me." Peter replied, "Even if I all fall away on account of you, I never will." "Truly I tell you," Jesus answered, "this very night, before the rooster crows, you will disown me 3 times. This song is called "We Remember You." And now, a reading from the Gospel of Mark. I've never had such trouble with this guitar. Thank you. As usual, Andrea saves the day. A reading from Mark, chapter 14, verses 32 through 36. Jesus and his disciples went to a place called Gethsemane, where he said to them, "Sit here while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John along with him and began to be deeply troubled. "I am overwhelmed with sorrow, even to the point of death. Remain here and stay awake." Going a little farther, Jesus fell to the ground and prayed, "Abba, Father, all things are possible for you. Take this cup from me. Yet not my will, but yours be done." A reading from Matthew chapter 26, selected verses. Jesus returned from his place of prayer to find his disciples sleeping. "Get up," he said to them, "for my betrayer is at hand." While he was still speaking, Judas arrived, accompanied by a large crowd with swords and clubs. Judas came up to Jesus and said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you came here to do." Immediately they stepped forward and seized Jesus. He said to the crowd, "Have you come with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I sat in the courts of the temple teaching, and yet you did not arrest me. But all of this has taken place so that the writings of the prophets may be fulfilled." Then all of the disciples deserted Jesus and fled. This song is called "Must Jesus Bear the Cross Alone?" A reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 22, verses 66 through 71. The next morning, the council of the elders, both the chief priests and the teachers of the law, met together as Jesus was brought before them. They said to Jesus, "If you are the Messiah, tell us." Jesus answered, "If I tell you, you will not believe." Then they asked, "Are you then the Son of God?" He replied, "You are correct in saying I am." "What further testimony do we need?" they said. "We have heard it ourselves from his own lips." Then they brought Jesus before Pilate. But Pilate said to the chief priests and crowds, "I find no basis for a charge against this man." But they were insistent. Pilate, after learning that Jesus was under Herod's jurisdiction, sent him to Herod. But finding nothing for which to convict him, Herod sent him back to Pilate. Finally, Pilate said to Jesus' accusers, "I have examined this man in your presence and have not found him guilty of any of your charges, neither has Herod, for he sent him back to us. He has done nothing to deserve death." Then they all shouted, Away with this man. Release Barabbas. Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again. But they kept shouting, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" The shouts of the crowd eventually prevailed. Pilate finally granted their demand. He released the one who had been imprisoned for insurrection and murder, and he handed Jesus over to them as they had desired. This song is called "How Beautiful."
To pay.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 22, verses 54 to 62. The crowd took Jesus into the house of the high priest. Peter followed at a distance. And when some there had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and had sat down together, Peter sat down with them. A servant girl saw him seated there in the firelight. She looked closely at him and said, "This man was with him." But Peter denied it. "Woman, I don't know him," he said. A little later, someone else saw Peter and said, "You also are one of them." "Man, I am not," Peter replied. About an hour later, another asserted, "Certainly this fellow was with him, for he is a Galilean." Peter replied, "Man, I don't know what you're talking about." Just as he was speaking, the rooster crowed. The Lord turned and looked straight at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word the Lord had spoken to him, "Before the rooster crows today, you will disown me three times." And Peter went outside and wept bitterly. This song is called "Must Jesus Bear the Cross Alone?" It's verse 2. A reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 23, selected verses. As they led Jesus away, they seized Simon of Cyrene, and they laid the cross on him, making him carry it behind Jesus. A large number of people followed him, including many who mourned for him. When they arrived at the place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there, along with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." One of the criminals kept deriding Jesus. "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God? We have been condemned justly and are getting what we deserve, but this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "Today you will be with me in paradise." It was now about noon, and darkness swept over the whole land. The curtain of the temple was torn into two. Then Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, Into your hands I commit my spirit. When he had said this, he breathed his last. And now a reading from 1 John chapter 4, verse 10. This is what love is. It is not that we have loved God, but that God loved us and sent his Son to be the means by which our sins are forgiven. Please pray with me. Loving God, how humbling and how amazing is your grace. How endless and perfect is your love. For you know each and every one of us, you call us by name, and you welcome us into your arms. This day, let us feel your loving arms around us. Let us rejoice anew for the gift of eternal life. And let us determine that we will pick up our cross daily and follow you. In Jesus' most precious name, amen.
Amen.
And now, as we bring this time of worship to a close, may we leave this place with the assurance of forgiveness that is made possible through the sacrifice of Christ. Go forth in hope and anticipation of the ultimate victory that comes with Easter. Amen and amen. Go now in peace.